carbon. So you got a hydrocarbon, and what's a hydrocarbon? Well, plastic is a hydrocarbon, like this pen is made out of. Concrete is a hydrocarbon. Glass is a hydrocarbon. Steel is a hydrocarbon. Let freedom ring. Iron's a hydrocarbon. But they add, when you add carbon to steel, it makes, carbon to iron, it makes steel. Then you throw a little manganese in there, give it a little nickel, make it ductile, so it's got flexibility. But this factor of 6.3 is unique. What is C4 explosive, or thermite, made out of? 6.3 plastic. When a 6.3 molecule explodes, which is plastic explosive, it only affects a 6.3 molecule. And what it does is, by an electromagnetic pulse, which is 1,300 feet round like this, it takes every single molecule that's in that of concrete, steel, and glass and reduces it to a single atom called smoke. Now, asbestos, which is lined in both buildings, is not a 6.3 molecule. So the asbestos, because of the shockwave of a 6.3 explosion, this stabilizes the asbestos, and that's that big white cloud that took off to the northwest when the buildings came down. Now, the exact second this took place, all of a sudden you got this is all smoke here. You can't actually see the building. And five seconds later, it's still, the building's all down in the basement, nice and neat, in the packed down in the basement. Now, there were 13 buildings that were 30 to 50 stories tall around the 103-story building of the World Trade Center. They all fell down under their own gravity because they were caught in the gravity well, which took their concrete, steel, and glass and reduced it to smoke also. They weren't on fire. But you know, all these buildings around the World Trade Center were also empty when they went down. Everybody was told to stay home that day. And there's 50,000 people a day that work in the World Trade Center for 30 years exposed to asbestos in the walls. Jeez, how's that for an insurance lawsuit for asbestos? Now, how are you going to pay 50,000 people for 30 years? Well, that's trillions of dollars of liability against the government. Because guess who owns the World Trade Center?
Port
authorities in New York City, which is the post office, which controls the treasury and owns the money. Ooh, that's the whole United States budget in two buildings. That's a real eyesore. If you take a look at the two planes that both flew in and you magnify them, there were no windows in any of the two planes. They didn't have windows, they were drones. Nobody died in that thing except the people in the buildings. Okay, so at the same time, they've got to solve this asbestos problem, and they got to bring this building down, and they got to do it quick. But then they want to blame somebody else in a different country. They want to go into Iraq, secure the 1/3 of the world's richest light sweet crude oil. And of course, King Hussein's out there killing his own people and that, so this is a good, you know, let's be the good guy and stop genocide program. But at the same time, we need an excuse to drop these two buildings. If we took them apart little by little, it would take years. They'd have to put a big plastic bubble over this thing. It would cost hundreds of dollars an hour for thousands of people to clean this all up. So let's cook up an act of war, get an act of war. So the United States military, 186 soldiers, were involved with the cord placement in the elevator shafts of the C4. When the C4 is detonated, and you can watch the explosions go ping, 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 all the way down as this thing is coming down. Now, how do you take a 4-foot-thick I-beam with a 2-inch web on it and turn it into smoke in 1 millisecond?
You cut it.
No, you don't cut it. You expose it to C4, gravitational wave. When the gravitational wave takes place, C4 has 85,000 pounds per square inch pressure wave. It takes all the concrete, steel, and glass molecules and reduces them to single atoms. So even though you're looking at a World Trade Center, it's actually a column of smoke. And every single computer that's in this computer in the building also is made out of plastic and silica, which is a 6.3 molecule. The only thing that's in there that really isn't is a gold processor. But once everything is vaporized, the gold can turn into dust and disappear with the rest of it. Now, what happened at the exact point of detonation? $12 trillion was transferred out of the World Trade Center through Honolulu, Hawaii, where one of my bankers is sitting, one of my students who works for the Hawaiian government, and monitored a $12 trillion transfer out of the World Trade Center into the Singapore Bank, world's largest bank. So we had $500 million a year for the next 22 years to supply the war machine to keep the oil flowing from Iraq. That's what happened there. That was a bank robbery. Then they blew out the basement floor, and 1 hour before the World Trade Center was hit, all the subways were shut down in New York City. The military came in, and what runs underneath the World Trade Center? Heavy rails for the subway. They blasted, at the same time this went off, they blasted the basement floor, which is concrete and steel, in the gold vaults, and they stole all the gold from the World Bank. This is the World Bank. Loaded them onto the subway system, and that disappeared into wherever. So now you've got a bank robbery taking place. Now we have to go ahead and declare and blame it on somebody. So we find somebody in a foreign country who's got a lot of oil, blame it on him as a terrorist, and 3,800 people die in this accident where there should have been 50,000 people at the time of the blast. So it's just enough, just like Pearl Harbor, only 1,700 people died. Pearl Harbor was hit by the post office, which controls the military, but the military only bombed the postal ships, postal planes, and postal buildings. No civilian sites were hit during the bombing of Pearl Harbor. So it was a war between two postmasters who controlled their military. You see what's going on here? And here, the Universal Postal Union controls the post office. The post office controls the military, which owns the C-4. And the only section of the Pentagon that blew up and killing 186 men was Black Ops, where all the guys work that handle C-4 division. I am a muster master for the Pentagon. So is Russell. We both got our treaties back in 1999. To protect all U.S. troops from any acts of genocide by any government in the world, and we would be called in to disqualify the contracts if they're written like this here to make them go away and protect all of our troops. So we're the heroes of the military. Even though we're nice, quiet little mice here, we do enjoy those privileges. So the World Trade Center, I'm watching this thing, and I'm sitting there with a stopwatch again and again and again. It's 4.8 seconds. This thing came down. Somebody changed gravity. And being a person with chemistry background and coefficient of expansions because I got a heat treat tool steel, I know that 6.3 is the key. That was a smoking gun. And some guy driving a van into the basement or flying a plane up here, which heat goes up, says, well, the fire was raging so hot it melted the I-beams, which created a collapse. Well, how is fuel oil at 1,800 degrees going to melt steel I-beams that are encased in concrete and insulated with asbestos in 4.8 seconds when they're 4 feet thick and a half-inch web, and then do that to 1,300 feet of it all at once in 4.8 seconds? Even in free fall, it's against the law. It would take months for that building to melt itself down. So this here was a telltale to bring both of them down and allowed me to put on a one-hour program about how C4 was used to the demolition of both buildings. And everyone on this planet who's ever touched explosives, the dropped buildings, said this was the cleanest demolition ever exercised in the history of demolition. To put it into the basement and not even make it fall over anywhere. Because when the wave collapsed, it took smoke and brought smoke into the basement. Now, when they went to clean up this big mess, while all that smoke came down, it didn't grab on to the asbestos. That got blown away in the wind and killed and contaminated 10 million New Yorkers. That's why I have all these lawsuits out there for asbestos with the lungs. So then, you know, a few hours later or so, then the Pentagon got hit. Then Flight 93, they made a movie, they played the videos. The 737 weighs 238 tons. Titanium titanium blades on the engines, they're ceramically coated. It takes 4,800 degrees to melt one of those puppies. And they're 100 degrees. Let freedom.